This is RSCKY, the YouTube Tech Guy. All right, guys, we're gonna get right into this. We are getting a tech rant about the Pixel XL 2 and its display. And this display is one of the worst displays I've seen on a flagship in a long time. Unfortunately, all these rumors and everything and all these things you've been hearing about this display are true. Quite frankly, it really is sucky because my first impressions video is going to go up tomorrow on the Pixel XL 2 and it's going to be mixed, and a lot of this mix comes from the display. The display is just not what I expect on this kind of caliber of an OLED display. And there really is no reason for it. Now, I don't have the LG V30, thanks LG, because with that phone, it had the same kind of display issue where you have the tilt thing. Now, what the tilt thing is basically when you look at it a little bit off to the side, just a little bit, like if you're doing, like showing someone else your display and you're pointing at it, it already is going to look bad because of a extreme shift in either blue or green. It varies depending on which phone you have, apparently. Now, here's the thing. That doesn't bother me that much. If that's on the V30, that wouldn't bother me that much. What does bother me is when I look dead on it, it doesn't look good. It looks less vibrant than an IPS display on an iPhone. You shouldn't have that kind of comparison with an OLED display. Every top flagship does have OLED displays, whether it be from LG or whether it be AMOLED from Samsung. These are going to be the best of the best screens, and there's a reason for it. Better brightness, better color, saves battery life. These are all reasons to get OLED displays, so it makes sense. But you have to have a good one. You have to make me look at this and like, oh yes, this is an OLED display. All of these colors aren't neutral, Google. They aren't neutral. None of these, your Yelp icon shouldn't be crimson red. And that's what I get. Allow us to control the RGB ourselves or do different kind of color profiles like Samsung does, where they'll do like an adaptive display. They'll do a vibrant one, they'll do a regular one. Your vibrant is 10% more vibrancy. You said that you would change it if people requested it. Well, guess what? Everyone is requesting it. Everyone has said that you need to fix this display. So yeah, we're requesting it. So change it, because that is probably one of the worst features about this phone. And it really sucks that all these YouTubers, because of, you know, the PR release and everything, they got the phone early. They didn't even hit on it more on their reviews. Now they're kind of hitting on it after. But really, that is a big issue because, quite frankly, if someone asked me right now, again, this is first 24 hours kind of thing, would you recommend the Pixel XL 2? Not right now. No, I wouldn't. You need to get the software update before getting this out because it's not good. It really is. It's so dull. And although some people might say, and some trolls in the comment section are probably type, are you serious? You're overreacting, like, you know, all this kind of stuff. But the display is the thing you look at every single day you use your phone. You're going to use this phone for over a year. It is nowhere near the level of an OLED display, but not even that. It's not near the level of other displays, of an LCD display. I don't understand why that is. It's just, you know, yes, people do like more vibrant than neutral. Get over it. I always hate when the experts say like, oh, well, I like a more neutral palette. Shut the hell up. Like, seriously, you are a minority. Most people like more vibrant. You know why? That's why all the highest TVs that sell on the market are always the more vibrant ones. People like those more because it looks better to our eyes. We like shiny, you know. See the Moana movie if you want to know more. But basically, you know, that's the whole thing about it. So, in my opinion, yeah, it really does need to change. But even if you don't like vibrant colors, to me, these aren't even neutral. They aren't. Because they don't look like the regular colors do on an IPS display, on a regular LCD. I mean, this is on par with more $200, $100 smartphones that I review. And I'm not over-exaggerating on that. That's how the level of color and brightnesses on this phone. So let me know what you guys think. And Google, I hope you do. And as soon as Google does an update, I will definitely do a video on it because yes, I do like other things about this phone, but that the display itself, the thing you look at every day, is a hard thing to get over. Let me know your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Do you have one of these phones? Have you had this issue? Let me know your thoughts. I'm very curious to hear them. Thank you as always for watching. This has been RICKY, the YouTube Tech Guy. Thank you for watching our video. If you liked it, why don't you go ahead and subscribe up there. Make sure you follow us on social media right here. And of course, check out our latest video up there. And right down here, you're going to find the perfect video for you. Or at least that's what YouTube tells me. Thanks again.